excerpt was taken from the Full & Bloom interview with photographer Mark Weiss. You can listen to the entire interview at fullandbloom.com. You also did the cover for Dawkins' Under Lock and Key, right?
Yeah, that was a funny one, huh? I mean, that was my doing. It kind of was because I did the art direction on it. But, you know, I was just following instructions. They came up, Ray Brown did the outfits, their waiter outfits, as we called it. And each guy got a color. And, you know, 85 was like, that was the time when everyone was glammed up at the max. Ozzy was glammed up, even Poison, of course. That's where it came from. You know, Motley Crue, Guns N' Roses, you know, everyone was. For that, those 2 years, 85, 86, that was the motion in rock, hard rock, and metal. You know, they were just going for that. And then it quickly moved to street again when Guns kind of got street.
Yeah, I like that in your book where you're talking about the division. Even like you were doing the Poison photo shoot, you got mugged and lost those photos.
Yeah, that wasn't fun at all. Yeah.
It's really after that you talk about the next time. I wondered that if those photos that you lost, were they still kind of glammed? And then you go in to do the photos for the album, which I think is like 88 or 89, and you're like,
yeah.
Okay, go ahead and get ready. And they're like, we are ready, man.
Yeah, they were probably glad that film was lost, you know, because, you know, they didn't, that was in between the record. They didn't know where they wanted to go. They wanted to keep themselves known in the magazines, and they didn't want to, you know, they didn't want to give up anything. They didn't want to give, you know, there's so many bands coming out at the time, they just wanted to stay in the loop. So I did the photo shoot. And then at some point they made a conscious decision, obviously, to go no more street.
So they were more glammed out, those photos that were lost, just in that little short window they changed?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, and they weren't really glammed out, but they were just definitely, you know, they were cropped, you know what I mean? They had a little hairspray in still and a little bit of makeup, nothing like 85, but, you know.
Of course, yeah.
They were toned down, but.
You did a whole bunch of photos of Dawkins throughout their career, but did you ever notice any of the tension between the two guys, George and Don?
Oh, yeah, of course, yeah. I mean, I used to live at Don's house, so I heard it all the time, 24/7, you know. They weren't shy about it at all. Even in the press, they kind of made a joke about it.
So you lived at his house?
Yeah, he gave me keys. Yeah, we were buddies. You know, he gave me keys, and when he was on the road, I stayed at his house, and when he was there, I stayed on the couch. Same with Kevin Dubrow.
When you're doing a photo shoot with Dawkins, can you like sense it while you're shooting them?
Yeah. I was the guy that kind of broke the ice and like said everything's gonna be okay, and you know, joked around and. You know, George really at that time, he wanted to be a guitar player. You know, he didn't want to do anything else. You know, he liked taking photos, but more by himself than with a band. He just didn't feel comfortable, I don't think, in front of the camera with other people there and taking direction and just kind of being like not himself. He was good in front of the camera on his own, but once you put him in there with a band, it was like pulling teeth.